The McElroy brothers are not experts, and their advice should never be followed. Travis insists he's a sexpert, but if there's a degree on his wall, I haven't seen it. Also, this show isn't for kids, which I mention only so the babies out there will know how cool they are for listening. What's up, you cool baby?
If you change your mind, take a chance on the first in line. Honey, I'm still free. Take a chance on me. If you need me, let me know. Gonna be around. If you got no place to go when you're feeling down. If you're all alone, where the pretty birds have flown.
Can you hear it there? There, there in the distance. Like an echo.
From a distance, MBMBaM is watching me. So don't masturbate, or we'll see it. We see everything.
We've always been watching you from the time you were born to today. And we'll watch you for like a week after you die.
I'm just going to go ahead and stay out of this one.
You Travis is right staying out. This is a song about my brother and me. It's syncopated, so you know we've worked a long time on it.
Justin, when are you going to auto-tune that shit?
That's all been auto-tuned. I did that in post. I say that knowing Griffin edits the show and probably didn't put it into auto-tune. This is an advice show for the modern era. My brother and me. I am your oldest brother, Justin McElroy.
I'm your middlest brother, Travis McElroy.
I'm Griffin McElroy, and I'm not related to you.
He don't like labels.
I don't subscribe to labels or podcasts, but I do subscribe to Reader's Digest.
Label cubby holes in...
You can't fit me in them.
Preschools, not people. That's what I say.
Square peg.
I actually couldn't exist without labels.
Triangular hole.
Whoa, this got deep, I feel
I've got that memento disease.
Oh, you got momentum. Mementitis.
Yeah. Do you mean that clean slate disease?
Yes.
You remember that?
Jerry Duty that disease. Movie?
Holy shit, clean slate. Why did you remind me that existed?
Sorry.
Dear my brother me, what do you do when your brother reminds you that clean slate existed?
You stop what you're doing, you rush out and you rent it from your local Movie Max.
Was it Dana Carvey?
Yes.
I really can't remember.
For a while,
it was Memento.
It basically is Memento.
It's basically Memento Carvey, before with the church Memento lady.
Hello, brothers McElroy. I have one simple question. What is my brother me stance on night showering as morning showers? I tend to have a terrible morning hair, and I use a shower as a double whammy of cleanliness and manageable locks. Where do you stand?
I am totally right there with you.
So this question is saying you take a shower at night, and that counts as your morning shower when you wake up, so you don't have to shower before you go to work or school or whatever.
There's nothing... Why would you give up on that most energizing part of your day? Mm-hmm. Like, nothing gets me ready to say, like, yes, let's do this, like a morning shower. If I have one of those at night, my body's like, what are we doing? This is awesome. Let's do something. This is going to be great. It's like, nobody... Go to bed, you dumb bitch. I tricked you again. First Dexatrim, and now this. You dumb motherfucker. You'll fall for anything.
I tend to shower, this sounds like a joke, but in the summer, like 3 times a day.
Yeah, I've never seen
once in the morning, because
like
I get that funky bedhead too. Mm-hmm. And I'll just like hop in and rinse, and then go on about
Travis
my day.
Gets a hairstyle that you'd pay hundreds, if not thousands of dollars for in Hollywood. But
well, I have that amazing hair that people only dream about. So there's that.
But when you dream about it, it looks terrible the next day. So
yeah.
You gotta have another shower in the morning. And then what do you just treat yourself to a midday? I don't know. What are you doing with your day? You're like, you know, be better than this. Standing underwater.
Yeah. And then I take one when I get home from work because I work hard building stuff. Okay. And then I take one before I go to bed so that I'm not all dirty when I get on my nice white sheets.
Hey. What are you doing in those 4 hours?
Between the second shower
Between
and third shower?
Between second and third shower, Bilbo. What are you
doing? Well, that's me time. And
Travis lives a lifestyle that a lot of us aren't, we just can't wrap our minds around.
Let's just say handmade jelly bracelets aren't going to hand make themselves, okay? Leave it at that.
Where do you think all these lanyards come from?
If you can only have one, though, night shower or morning shower.
It's got to be morning shower.
I think it's got to be morning shower. If only because bed bugs are really big right now. Everyone's got them.
the latest thing.
Everyone's cool got thing. Those bed bugs. And
you know
so
who
you gotta,
I heard had them?
Joaquin you got to use them in the morning. You got to use a shower and eradicate them from your body.
Don't even go to Hollywood if you don't have a Twitter account with at least 1,000 followers and bed bugs. This is just that style today. That's where we're at as a nation.
Have you ever seen a bed bug?
Yeah.
I've seen Joaquin Phoenix.
He's a bed bug.
He's a bed bug. He's a hyper-evolved bed bug.
Hey, guys.
Bed bugs.
Hey, guys. So when I got married, I discovered that my in-laws ask their children and children-in-law for Christmas wish lists. Every time I fill it out and mail it in, I feel like a kidnapper handing over a list of demands. I mean, it's nice to get DVDs and board games I know I like, but the spontaneity is completely lost. Am I right for feeling awkward, or am I just being ungrateful? Thanks, fellas. You really know how to rock and roll. Lehman, Gmail.
Ooh. Thanks, Lehman.
I've been in this exact same situation. That is how my in-law family rolls. And what I've done for the past few years is that I've just asked for a bunch of different styles and sizes of my brother and me t-shirts. And I feel like it's a gift that's not only fun to get, but also to give. And it makes me feel better about it.
I feel like since we're on the subject, let's have a brief aside just for a moment. You got your t-shirt.
I did.
You may be the first human.
Maybe the first human to have my t-shirt.
How can you describe it? Describe the whole experience of it, really.
I opened it and it smelled like a t-shirt.
Okay,
and then I put it on. And
how does it feel?
Like, there was a line. It was a comical line of girls out my front door, just one after the other, just like, please, anything.
Can I smell your chest?
Can I smell your chest?
New from Max Body Spray.
Would you describe it as soft or rough and confident? Or
no, it's soft. It's soft and like it's got a nice little stretch to it.
Oh yeah.
So like yeah. So you like it's really comfortable. My wife got one too, and since she got it, I had to change my full time career to fool smashing because I just got to smash so many fools who come up, and they're like, "Hey, lady, nice taste in t-shirt." actually, this is true. She worked to get her hair did, and when she got back, I said, well, "Did you tell her about your t-shirt? Did you explain it to her? Did you tell her about the show? What's the point of you going out in public with it if you're not going to do that?" But those should are coming now. So
they should be arriving this week. If you
could still, and soon to follow are ask me about my t-shirt bumper stickers.
Ask me about the t-shirt I'm wearing, unless it's that those 29 days of the month that I'm not wearing my brother me t-shirt.
I have good news.
Tell me.
No, I'm saying that's
how about Jesus would say the t-shirts
when asked about the t-shirts.
So those are going right now. You can still totally get them. We have all sizes and shapes and colors. At MBMBaM.com. But
so, Lehman, to answer your question.
But Lehman.
Here's the thing. You're their in-law, dude. They don't know you. They
right,
don't know what
exactly.
to get you.
Exactly.
You got to get that
people
list,
who
man.
Do lists, from what I've found, are people who like to keep the balance of like how much they're spending on people. So like you have to accept the fact that they're going to spend X amount of dollars on you anyway. Mm-hmm. And it'll make them happy to get you things that you will like. So like you're meeting them halfway on this, because think about when you're trying to buy a gift for somebody you don't know very well. It is the worst. You're like, well, they like this. Will this be too personal? You're basically just saving them a lot of trouble.
And I had friends, and I have friends to this day, that for like Christmas and birthdays, all they get is like a big stack of gift cards.
That's the
and
worst.
And, like, I would much rather just give someone a list and actually get things in boxes and paper
yeah.
than just a big stack of gift cards. Because that's like saying, hey, you do the shopping.
Hey, go nuts.
And really, what is more awkward? You turning in a list of demands of things that they will get you that you know you will like, or them buying you, like, a build-your-own-brick pizza oven kit because they saw you eating pizza one time, and then you have to like it and then build it in your backyard.
Put on the list, you've already given me the greatest gift, which is your daughter, but if you insist on getting me something else, And then just do that every year. You'll never feel bad about it.
Mm-hmm. And always put on there just over and over again the Ewok playset.
If you don't give me this, I'll hate you forever.
Thanks for the daughter and everything, but I would really like that battle for indoor playset.
That would take her place as the greatest gift. Hi, my name is Ben. God, that playset rules.
Hi, my name is Ben. Traps and shit. Ah, oh, fucking.
Awesome. I have a net. I have a life conundrum, says Ben. I'm going into high school and I like a girl a lot. I know that homecoming is going to be coming up, so I want to ask her. This is an issue of her not liking me, having good looks, or me not having the balls to do it. I just want to be creative when I ask her. Sadly, my creative juices haven't been flowing, and I need an idea. Got any? Don't do it at school, I feel like, because you run a... In high school is such a tightrope of cultural acceptance that I think you run the risk of embarrassing her if you do anything outlandish at school. That's my stance.
But, what I mean, maybe he only... Maybe he only sees her at school.
Okay. Put a dead horse head in her locker.
Yeah.
See, I like that. Okay. The trick is, kids' lockers today, they're so small. So it's really just going to have to be a pony head.
So put a pony head in there.
Which may be upsetting for her.
Yeah.
Or, okay, gain access to all the lockers around her and install all the parts of a pony into the locker so that when they're all open together, it's a pony that says, "Will you go to homecoming with me?" But sure. Also it's dead.
But also it's dead, like it's dead as fuck. Like nobody's ever been deader than this pony. It's like quadrisected into several parts. Octosected.
Have you ever thought about a large quartet?
Have you considered a large quartet? I say, gosh, it's so hard. High school was so long ago. I feel like that was 150,000 years ago for me.
Hijack a pep rally.
Oh, wow. I like this.
Turn it on its ear from being about the success of the basketball team and instead turn it into a romantic opportunity.
Say, it would be a slam dunk if I could get to third base with you after the homecoming dance, but first you have to go with me. So let's get it started.
And then play the Black Eyed Peas song, Let's Get It Started.
And then have a cheer routine, a one-man cheer routine worked out to it. This sounds good.
Mm-hmm. Make her a mix CD.
Make her a mix CD of all Black Eyed Peas.
I've got a feeling.
Ooh, homecoming's gonna be a good night.
We're gonna go to Applebee's. Then we'll dance to rap music.
From 3 years ago.
Ooh.
Request stroke and they don't play it. Greatest dance night ever. God, there's a lot of music in this episode. It's like a musical episode, I think. It's closest we're ever going to get.
Hey, I've got a Yahoo Answers question.
Please, okay. Do tell.
It comes to us from Robert Allen Cullen, which is a bad start. He asks,
it's not a good start, but keep going.
What would I have to do to become a wizard? I would like to become either a vampire or a wizard, and I haven't gotten anything too promising on becoming a vampire. So I would like some information, some steps to take to become a wizard.
Well, Robert, I'm glad you asked. I have some pamphlets here that I think you might be interested in.
Not about wizard, but about... I run like an anti-Harry Potter school that teaches kids that their magic is shameful.
Have you thought about the magic of our Lord and Savior?
Jesus Christ, he means?
That's the
Have
thing.
Have you thought about that magic?
I think when a lot of people hear the word wizard, they think magic. I think there are
or
a lot
Star
of,
Wars Episode 1.
There are a lot of elements of the wizard lifestyle that I think you can adopt without, you know, knowing how to...
Okay,
to
good.
Cast
Step
magic.
One.
Like,
beard. Beard up day one.
Beard?
Get yeah.
Naked day two.
Naked day two because you're a wizard. Gotta keep save something.
A long
blue
robe.
Yeah, a long robe.
You need a familiar.
How are your sleeves?
Hey, you're. By the way, everybody in class, your little brother doesn't count as your familiar. Way to put the effort into it. Not at all.
And don't spray paint your cat. It seems like a good idea at first. Just spend the extra money and get the black cat with all the extras.
Yeah. It's worth it for the features. Like that tail you can crank to cast spells.
Mm-hmm. you need to capture some villagers and lock them in your basement.
Uh-huh. Oh, you're going like Evil Wiz.
No. I mean, that's a natural. Have you not read Harry Potter?
I think you might have been reading an offshoot series.
So
did you check these out on harrypotter.info/fanstories?
I actually I read Helter Skelter. That's my bad. That's on me.
That's
so
on you.
Is the theory we're working on here that if you have all the trappings of wizardry and you do all the thing, that magic powers just come? Like you wake up one morning and your beard is just long enough and so you can levitate things?
Yeah. Have you ever seen the Santa Claus? Yes. Claus spelled C-L-A-U-S-E, as in like a legal clause.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
It's whoa, like, this is already funny.
It's kind of...
Slow down, I didn't make it past the title. God, Tim Allen, you know, he knows exactly where my funny bone is, like surgical strike style.
And what I
he
love is exactly that really opens it up for sequels.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. How old is too old to wear skinny jeans for fellows? Jarrett asks.
Well, Jarrett, what age are you? Because that age.
This is like asking when a fetus is a fetus. When is it a baby? Because the answer is at conception.
Now, if you got a fetus wearing skinny jeans, we are down with this.
That's the coolest baby ever.
Yeah, but we've already come out in favor of babies wearing hipster jeans. I feel like skinny jeans.
I say okay. Screw it, man. If that look works for you, just go for it.
I was about to say 30, but I'm almost 30 and I wear skinny jeans on the reg. It's all about what signal you want to send out, Jarrett. If you want to send out the signal that you're someone's not wearing those for comfort. They're wearing those because they want to make an impression on people.
Mm-hmm.
And you're saying, hey, I'm putting the effort into it. What's up,
ladies? I want my fanny meat to look like some grade A material.
I want it, and I want it out there on display.
I'm not ashamed to wear pants that lift and separate.
Yeah. I want to advertise as much as Scott Pilgrim has been advertised. I want it out there like SP.
Hey, come get this butt.
Hey, did you...
I think you're crossing into a different signal that you might not want to be sending.
Hey, do you want some butt? I've got some for you.
This butt is yours. Just kidding, it's mine. I keep it in these skinny jeans.
You want a
slice?
This
butt's for you.
Do you like some? Would you like some butt?
Who gonna carve up this butt?
Who's gonna carve up this butt? For once, several of my friends still dream big. Says Jeff from Gmail. And I have ideas for greater things. One always has movie ideas. Another has ideas for opening a cafe. I don't think that's an idea. And that's not even a particularly clever one. But anyway, moving on. Me, I don't recall having a good idea in years. Years. What could I do to get them think meet sparks firing? Says Jeff from Gmail. Jeff, the world can't be full of leaders. There's got to be someone who shows up on day one with a hammer and says, point me in the right direction of your dream. Let me help you build it for an equitable share of the profits.
Jeff, let me take that one step further. Every hero needs his arch nemesis. So hang out with these friends, and every time they have an idea, you shoot it down. You poke holes in every single thing they say.
They
I have an
naysayer.
Idea for a movie.
Right, that's so they can rub it in their face and be like, take that, Jeff.
But the thing is, one has movie ideas, the other one wants to open a cafe. I guarantee you those are both terrible ideas, whatever they are. And I guarantee you they will never, ever do those things, Jeff. You need to come up with, like good, practical ideas that you will actually use in your daily life. Like, small victories. Like, I'm going to make a peanut butter and jelly sandwich with waffles for bread. Like, fuck yeah, awesome idea, Jeff. Go do that.
Yeah, and then you only need one good idea. Mm-hmm. Take Richie Napster. He came up with the idea of fuck paying for music. Fuck it. And look where he is today. Or, I don't know where Richie Napster is today, but I mean, I'm sure he's got a lot of money.
What about Google Jones?
Google Jones is another great example. Just invent searching for shit.
Mm-hmm.
That guy had one good idea. I want to find some things on the web. It's like a big stack of papers before that, just piled on somebody's desk. And Google Jones is I need to find one of these papers. And three people had a heart attack just hearing his idea. Like, of course. Of course, GJ. What did we think of this before? And they helped him build it. They helped him build a service, which actually was called Searcho. And someone was like, wait a minute. Your first name is Googs.
Googs. Googs, use your name.
Let's Google. Call it Jones.
Build on their ideas. If one has a movie about two buddy cops, and they're like both hard-nosed, but they're both former presidents, call it Founding Fighters. Like, just come up with something really dope that builds on their idea.
And or just steal
it.
Their idea.
Yeah.
Or just steal it.
That's a great idea.
Well, it's not so much
open
stealing.
Open up a movie
much,
cafe.
It's not so much stealing as much as it is like when you play Price is Right and you bet $1 over what the person before you bet.
So if they do a movie about two buddy cops, you do one about three buddy cops.
That would be actually a really great movie.
Or just
and just like, the one cop's in the back seat all the time going, can we get like a burger or something?
I'm really hungry. Maybe when they tell them your ideas, combine them and then shoot them down together. Say, I'm going to make a movie about how your cafe is going to close.
It will do very poorly in the box office.
Just like another movie I know about, yours. Laura from Gmail had a story about her boyfriend arguing about condoms and whose job it is. And she basically asked... we've experienced the wide world of hookups and dating. Whose job is it to provide the condoms?
Laura, that's awfully presumptive of you.
Griffin has taken a pledge to be chaste until he dates someone.
TLW, ladies.
TLW. True love waits. The guys.
That's... See, I went a step further.
Okay.
And I had a condom surgically attached to my penis.
Yeah. Oh, God. God. I just
sometimes
yucked.
I just try to make Griffin sad.
I yucked in my coffee cup. How does that... So you can use it once?
No, that's the problem. He just keeps using it. If it accidentally gets punctured, it's considered a biological weapon. What is in there? What did you do? God. You killed 30 people. Why are you standing with your pants around your ankle and a gas mask on? What are you doing?
I'm the new outbreak monkey.
I'm patient zero. Like, my wiener is patient zero.
Are you wearing a fanny pack underneath your pants?
I wish.
Oh, Jesus.
I wish I'd put the forethought into this surgically attached condom.
That's why it was an outpatient surgery.
Here's my question, Travis. Did Blue Cross Blue Shield cover that?
Part of it?
Yeah.
It was, it took a lot of paperwork.
Yeah, I would imagine.
I had to convince him it wasn't elective.
He got jealous of NuvaRings. he wanted a similar, a masculine alternative.
Yeah.
Just everyone should carry them. They give them to middle schoolers. Just everyone provide them.
I'm confused. Doesn't everyone just have a box of six condoms that they had so long that they don't remember where they came from?
Yeah.
Doesn't everybody just have that?
I keep mine in an Altoids tin that has the words Jimmy Hats, like, crudely scrawled upon it in Sharpie. I got it in the fifth grade. A very sexually active 10-year-old. That's not true, Dad.
Hey, Laura, here's your answer. Whose job is it? Everyone's. Be safe, kids.
Johnny B says, I thought you'd enjoy this tale. I was in Southwest PA a few weeks ago for my fiancé's family reunion, and while en route to said reunion, I passed a sign for a road called Jessup Street. The completely mind-blowing thing was that some MBMBaM fan had put a handmade sticker of the word Mega in front of Jessup. Had I been driving, I would have pulled over for a snapshot, and sadly, we took a different way home. Hope you guys are doing great. Johnny B. Johnny B., I'm not sure that's true.
That's totally true. I've always said our shit is popping in Southwest PA.
Yeah, Southwest PA is probably like the epicenter.
I heard they're having an MBMBaM convention in Southwest PA.
It's called MBMBaM. There's a lot of weird letters in there.
Yeah, I don't even know.
Unfortunately, we weren't invited.
No, because they know we would have said no. Yeah. We have too many enemies.
They wanted to avoid that embarrassment.
Too many enemies in the Southwest PA area.
God knows that's true.
That's like what, Pittsburgh?
Is it?
I think so.
That's gross. If you're listening in Pittsburgh, I don't really think Pittsburgh gross. If you're not listening in Pittsburgh, I totally do.
Fuck that city.
Yeah. Yeah. And if you drive into Pittsburgh later, we don't think it's gross. I don't want you to think we're wrong about things. Because we're pretty much always right.
Yep.
Formspring. I've known my best friend for 8 years, but we never seem to talk about our feelings. We're both guys, so I guess that's normal. But I don't think we've ever hugged. Not even once. Oh, man. In tough times, we'd always use texts.
What?
What's the best way for us to open up?
I'm confused. Like, you're having a rough day, and you're like, "Ah!" And then you text him, even though he's sitting right next to you?
Hey, Brad, I'm too embarrassed to say this with my mouth, but you hurt my feelings.
Now, first of all, let's get past that we're guys, so it's normal. That ain't normal. Guys, open up. Don't give in
to stereotypes. Love each other, man. What are you worried about?
I think everyone's allowed to have one. Maybe not allowed isn't the right word. Very organically, everyone develops one male friend that they can talk to about the lonely times.
Yeah.
Yeah, when they come. What are you worried about? Is my question. Like, if you're worried that people are going to think you're undercover gay, like, nothing screams undercover gay more than I won't touch another man. Like, that's like, wow, self-hating.
Just Jeff, hug. There's a great idea for a movie, by the way.
Yeah, Jeff, if you want.
Undercover gay. The sequel to Undercover Brother.
I haven't talked about my feelings in close to 12 years, so I'm probably not the best person to feel
just
this.
Just bottle it up.
Bottle it up.
Here's my answer. Just at a really random time, just hug him. Just grab him hug him and whisper in his ear, "Don't let this be weird."
Perhaps at a ball game?
Yeah.
I like that.
Or maybe you're sitting front row watching Chris Kattan in Undercover Gay, and you just hug him and think, "I love you.
Thanks for getting me out of the house, Brad. Come get this.
Come get what I made.
Come in here. Come in
how do
here.
Hey, Brad, how do these skinny jeans look? Give me a hug.
I got you this hug. Now carve this butt.
Carve my butt, Brad. Carve it. If you didn't
not in a gay way though.
Not in a gay way, just carve my butt like in a straight just bros way. If you didn't answer my question on the show, will you respond eventually, says Formspring.
Oh boy.
Hey folks, you can still put your name on the Formspring question, okay?
Here's my suggestion. Send it again.
Whoa. Yeah. Well, that's going to open yourself up to a lot of work, isn't it?
I'm a man who lives in the now, Justin.
Yeah, listen today.
I don't worry about what happened yesterday or even 3 seconds ago.
What?
I have that memento disease.
I have mementitis. If it's still pressing, like if you really need help, send it again. We'll see what we can do.
But otherwise, probably not.
Probably not. We get a lot every week.
We do. I was thinking that we could.
We read them all.
We do read them all. Anything. We promise that. But I was thinking that what we could do is find one blanket answer that we can apply to just large swaths of questions that are similar. Maybe not one blanket answer, but like a handful of blanket answers to some of our most commonly asked questions.
Okay. Well, I call through a lot of the questions. So do you want me to give you guys the questions and you give me the answer?
I don't even think we need the questions. I think we can just say the answers and the people who ask the questions will know. Like, yeah, here's I've got one. Just kiss her, dummy.
Oh, yeah, just kiss her, dummy. Yeah. That takes care of a lot of it, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Just quit already.
Ooh,
that's a good one. They're not really your friend.
That's a big one. Horseradish.
Oh, yeah.
Just go to the doctor.
Mm-hmm.
It's not supposed to look like that.
That one can... those two are often conjoined.
Shots. That covers everything, right?
Yeah, that's just about it.
Those
I
are
have,
like
I have one more.
Okay.
What? Stop talking about masturbation, you freak.
You fucking
freaking
weirdos.
Everybody out, weird.
We
weirdos.
Asked. We asked so nicely. Don't be creepy anymore.
Specifically.
And the fucking next week, it was like, hey, I made a poop and masturbated it. both rules.
Hey, I masturbated my poop. Is that cool?
I made a poop and I masturbated on my poop and then I looked at it. Here's a picture.
Deal with it, Holmes. I seem to have a lot of trouble making and maintaining eye contact with other people during conversations. Any advice? Oh my God, I do the same thing.
Yeah, me too.
I don't have advice.
No, here's what.
I need your advice.
I've cultivated like this. I look off of their shoulders and try to look really thoughtful and pensive. So they're thinking, oh, he's having big ideas. But really, I'm bored.
I make up for it, though.
Hey, Travis. Hey, Travis, as somebody who's known you for your entire life, we're on to you. Okay. Oh.
I make up.
Damn it.
I make up for my lack of eye contact by keeping in constant physical contact with everyone I ever talk to. Either
just have a hand on the cheek.
Just a hand on the cheek, just constantly brushing hair away from their eyes and behind their ears, or holding their hands, or giving them like a light massage.
Here's what you need to do. Just unwavering eye contact. Intense, burning.
You're testing yourself, remember.
And if they try to look away, you start screaming, don't look away, don't look away.
It's like a firm handshake, staring somebody down. And it's important that you establish that dominance, I think.
Yeah.
I need help learning how to cook, says Thomas from Gmail. The only thing I know how to cook is the that's what it sounds like when I say quotations.
Kick! Apparently.
Kick! It's microwavable foods and tasty sandwiches. Both good. I have mastered both of these cooking techniques, but I need to know how to cook actual meals. I'm getting to the point where I will move out and live on my own soon. Are there any recipes or websites you could recommend to me? Thank you for the help, says Thomas from Gmail.
Before we get into funny things, I have a real answer that started my cooking journey. There's a series of books called A Man, A Can, and a Plan, A Man, A Can, and a Microwave, and A Man, A Can, and a Grill. Find these books. They're all like 6-ingredient recipes that take about 15 minutes. They are delicious and they are impressive. Go buy these books.
And they will give you diabetes.
And they will give you the diabetes.
You know, it really is about just trying it. I mean, what you can do is watch Food Network and just pick something that looks fairly easy and just try it.
And if you are a novice, Good Eats spells it out very plainly. It's very scientific.
Yeah, Good Eats. And Alton Brown writes some good books. You can check those out.
Otherwise, I will say pasta. Pasta is easy to make. So, so easy. You make like noodles and you buy some sauce. Comes pre-pro, and then you dump the sauce on the noodles, maybe some vegetables that you can steam in like a bag in a microwave. See, you're using the skills you already possess.
Also, you know what's great? Search on YouTube for Starving with Lewis. That's a friend of mine who does he does sort of like college cooking. But it's sort of like that, like evolving from ramen and stuff to not ramen. And he's got Suicide Girls on there sometimes, so it's good stuff
for the fellas. So that's,
if nothing else, pick out an ingredient that you're interested in. Like, I bought this eggplant, and then go online and search eggplant recipes.
But make sure whenever you announce that ingredient, you do it like the guy from Iron Chef.
Yeah. Eggplant!
Especially if you're alone in your kitchen. That will make the loading times worse.
Or standing in the middle of the supermarket.
Just go down the road.
And then take a bite out of it.
Cucumber! So I want to hear Griffin's last question. It's always a doozy. But a few housekeeping things. You can, if you want to ask a question, you can log on to MBMBAM.com. We have all the methods there. We're going to get a new site soon, hopefully. We're working on that right now for you. If you have any requests, you can, of course, email them to mbmbam@gmail.com. There are still plenty of t-shirts if you'd like to purchase those. The logo t-shirt we'll probably keep making some version of. The Jeffrey t-shirt not so
limited
much.
Limited edition.
So if you want one, get it. Is there anything else?
Thanks. Thank you.
Oh my God. Thank you. Of course.
So much.
We're nearing up on 200,000.
Yeah. Last week was our biggest download day by like 1,000. I don't know what
you
happened.
You guys are nuts.
But you guys killed it. You guys knocked it out of the water.
And we really appreciate everybody dropping quotes and just promoting the show, helping out. Twitter user My Beautiful Liar helped spread the word this week. Tony Lemon, he's out there doing God's work, telling people about MBMBaM. We appreciate it. Seriously, also, you guys have no idea.
I would like to thank my friend Alex Goodrich. Sent me a question from Wiki Answers that I think is going to be a whole new venue that we can travel down. So I wanted to say thank you for that.
Can't wait for that. And if you get a second, if you wouldn't mind subscribing on iTunes if you haven't already done that and leaving a rating or a review on iTunes, because when you do that, it helps us like move up the iTunes rankings, which helps even more people find our show. Yeah. Just if you get a second, I know you're busy, but
and tell everybody to download it on Monday. Mm-hmm. And when we do that, we go up. That's good, because that's the only way we're going to get huge.
And start contacting your local NPR station. Mm-hmm. And ask them why they
see
don't
if you
carry
can get
our
us
show
up on that shit.
Yeah, and ask your local county commission why they don't have an official My Brother and Me Day while you're at it.
Just think about it.
Griffin, grace us.
This Yahoo Answers question, it was sent in by fan of the show, Declan, which is just really, really cool.
The greatest.
Oh, wait. Before you read it, I got a letter from Tristan. He's doing great, but it sounds terrible what he's doing. It sounds really hard. But
surprisingly, boot camp really tough.
Boot camp really tough, but Tristan's doing well for people. You can write him. I think his address is in the Facebook group. Anyway, all right, good. Sorry.
Thank you, Tristan.
Sorry. Thank you, Tristan, for your service. Freedom.
Thank you. And thank you, Declan, for your service of sending in this question. This one is from Yahoo Answers user Chris. Who asks, how do I get help with the legalization of zoophile marriage?
Oh, God. I'm Justin McElroy.
I'm Travis McElroy.
I'm Griffin McElroy.
And this has been My Brother and Me. Kiss your dad. Square on the lips.
You will never know me.
Hey everybody, sorry we forgot to mention it during the show, but Jay Phonic has a new jam, Untitled, I think, but it's so fresh, and we have to put it in the show. So as a reward for sticking around, a little post-credits bonus, here is Jay Phonic's MBMBaM rap number 2.